New York House vote makes the president just the third one in history to be impeached. Now it's the Senate's turn to take up that case.
But with House Speaker Nancy Pelosi refusing to commit to when she will hand the articles of impeachment over to the Senate, things could hit a bit of a stalemate. WGN's political reporter Tamad Bradley in the newsroom for us tonight with the latest. Tamad?
Joe and Micah, today the country grappled with the historic impeachment vote. The implications stretch from Washington to Chicago.
He's just the third president in history charged with high crimes and misdemeanors. But today, he brushed it off.
I mean, we have the best economy in history, and if you remember the famous quote, it's all about the economy, stupid. Well, I never believed it was all about the economy, but the economy is a big thing.
President Trump's trial is set to begin in January, where a vote of two-thirds of the Senate is necessary to remove him from office. But Democrats want to delay sending the articles of impeachment to the Senate, hoping to gain leverage over the rules.
The next thing for us will be when we see the process that is set forth in the Senate.
Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell has indicated that he has already made up his mind.
This particular House of Representatives has let its partisan rage at this particular president create a toxic new precedent that will echo well into the future.
The Illinois congressional delegation voted on impeachment along party lines. For two freshman Democrats, their vote carries enormous political risk. Lauren Underwood of the 14th congressional district narrowly won her seat in 2018. She represents a Northwest exurb long held by Republicans. For Underwood, impeachment is complicated.
It also plays into kind of the Republican meme of, well, you're just a tool of Nancy Pelosi, and you'll just go along with what she does.
Sean Casten flipped another GOP seat in 2018. Republicans have set their sights on him. The frontrunner to win the Republican primary is former state rep Jeannie Ives, a conservative firebrand.
But assuming the general election is Ives cast, and you know what you're going to get out of that.
Democrats in reliably blue districts said it was imperative that Congress act.
This is a president, if he is not held accountable, will go on to higher crimes and misdemeanors, apparently.
It's unclear what the political impact on Republican candidates will be. If the Senate votes to acquit, Republicans say they do not fear repercussions. Joe and Micah. All right.